Hey, this is Red Band coming to you live from the world famous Comedy Store for a brand new episode of Kill Tony Volume 4. Gilbert Tony Oscar!
Hi, everybody. Hello. Wow, look at this. One of our biggest turnouts. Wow, how fun. July 4th, ladies and gentlemen, and we're celebrating comedy live. How fucking awesome is this? A lot of people blew it out, don't have any energy left, half capacity. Welcome, everybody. Hi, everyone. This is exciting. Happy July 4th. Yes, there you go. Start a USA chant. Maybe one of the 14 people in the room will continue it. Hi, Brian Redband. It's Brian Redband, everybody.
Hey,
come on. We're live,
Happy
everyone.
Four.
Fuck yeah.
We had a lot of fun last night. We went to go see Chicago at
Hell
the Hollywood
yeah.
Bowl.
We saw Chicago at the Hollywood Bowl.
That's a great place, man. We started a wave up. Don Barris, we were at the one side of this place.
Yeah.
We actually got it halfway through the whole entire place.
Yeah, I started
a
thing. I guided Don to begin it. But I became obsessed with us starting a wave.
I've never seen the beginning of one.
That's what's amazing, is starting the wave is the best thing. And it was my first time. I don't know what my gut made me do it, but I'm like, Don, when I say go, stand up, and everybody, and I like yell, I'm like, you guys are either in or you're out. And everybody's like, what's this guy so confident about? And we just started doing it, like, whoa, and it would go a little bit farther, and those people would be like, what are those guys? You'd hear the roar, whoa.
And then it would skip. Like, people would just stop, but then, like,
but
way down.
But you'd see people, like, way down, like, oh, they're starting a wave over there. Let's wait like it made it. It was great. It was like one of those really cool moments, you know, just controlling thousands of people's minds all at once.
Yeah.
Anyway, that was a fun highlight. You're right. Making that wave yesterday was fun.
It's neat.
Welcome to the show, everybody. Let's have some fun. Ryan J. E. Belt, the house artist, is right here. He's going to draw tonight's episode. He draws every single episode. Amazing artist. What you see tonight, you're going to see on a piece of paper at the very end of the night. You're going to see that the episode was somehow captured by this amazing fucking artist. All of his prints are at ryanjebelt.com. Back on the HD camera, for the people that watch this show in its finest glory, Jamie Vernon, ladies and gentlemen.
Young
the
Jamie.
Great Young Jamie. Youngjamie.com. Here we are, Brian.
Mm-hmm.
Dates coming up. Cleveland, Tulsa, San Francisco, Sacramento, San Diego, and Boston's Wilbur Theater. If you live in any of those places, I'm coming to you really soon, like Cleveland, next weekend. Not this weekend, but next weekend.
Cleveland.
Yeah,
nice.
Going back, that's my first time headlining Ohio by myself. It's pretty weird, so that's strange. Took a while to get there. Took a while to get where it all started, you know what I mean, guys? I'm from Ohio, for those of you that don't know that, which is everybody. So let's do this, shall we? Every single week, we have the coolest band in the world, and they're live every week. And I'm excited to see their July 4th edition. Here they are, ladies and gentlemen, Reagan and Watkins and Joel Jimenez. Oh my God.
Jamie.
Fuck yeah. Wow, very July 4th intro from Reagan and Watkins.
That burned my arm the entire way up.
A complete fire hazard for those of you listening to the podcast. We are, by the way, the number one live podcast in the world. I forgot to mention that. You're here. Welcome. If this is your first time, feel free to let it rip. Guys, that was one of my favorite intros ever. A very July 4th edition.
Very Great White.
For those of you listening to the podcast, yeah. It's like very good. You guys, for those of you listening to the podcast, they came up with sparklers that obviously went out right after they lit them. They were just four smoky sticks being waved in the air. And now the room has the distinct smell of cheapest possible Chinese fireworks.
Welcome to America, bro.
What kind of 99-cent store where you get sparklers where they just fizzle down like a hot fuse? Just pam! I literally watched them. They went out at the top of the stairs. Yeah. right after you lit them, they just burned down.
Yeah.
Where'd you guys get those?
I got them from a party that I was at earlier today.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah.
Jeremiah going to parties. Reagan and Watkins, everybody, here they are. I'm so excited you guys are here. This is the part where every episode I bring out tonight's guests. And this week I decided to do something super fun. It's always two of the funniest, best comedians in the world as our guests. And this is a very special episode because in this bare skeleton edition of Kill Tony, our two guests are Reagan and Watkins, ladies and gentlemen. Yes. This is the first time ever in Kill Tony's history where we are going bare bones.
OMG!
Feel free to do whatever you want.
Man.
You could be over here, you could go over there.
Oh, man.
Tonight, Kill Tony celebrates its independence.
What is happening? What is happening?
We don't need guests, bitches. It's so funny. We're just going to do it ourselves. Feel free to move around, do whatever you want.
This feels good.
If you want to throw one of those mics on Joel Jimenez, ladies and gentlemen, on the percussions.
Yeah. Dude, Tony, I have a sunburn, and then I just burnt my arms with the sparkler, so I'm not doing good right now.
Second degree burns on Jeremiah. So this is exciting. By the way, I sprung it on Reagan and Watkins, everybody.
He said he had a surprise for us.
Yeah, I told him I had a surprise for them. Happy 4th of July, guys. Welcome to the show.
Thank you very much, Tony.
Thank you.
How excited are you guys that tonight's guests are Reagan and Watkins?
Oh, yeah.
I'm hearing the murmurs from the comedians. And it is lovely. So you guys ready to rock or what?
Dude, I don't know. There's so many emotions going through me right now.
And I mean, you guys can do whatever you want at any point. Make it your own thing. If you want to play instruments, if you want to do whatever. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, mm-hmm. I like that.
Brian, what do you think about this? How do you feel about bringing Reagan and Watkins this close to the monster?
It's great. I really can't wait to see those two people on the message board that hate.
Yeah.
Just like, it's their worst day ever.
By the way, I don't know if you guys all know this. There's a guy out there that hates Pat Reagan so much that he started a petition with the federal government that requires 100,000 signatures for like a major thing. And the major thing that he submitted was remove Pat Reagan from Kill Tony, the podcast. And by the way, if I clicked on it because I'm like, you got to be fucking kidding me. I think I actually clicked on it twice. Like, I didn't sign the petition, but like, I couldn't help. Like, I was like, was that fucking real? And there was only one signature on the petition. And of course, it was the guy that started it and tweeted about it. But he started a federal petition. So he's losing his fucking mind right now in just furious anger. He's writing some blog. I've listened to every episode since it was the Iron Patriot. And here you are, Pat.
Hey, Pat, how does it feel to be hated more than the Iron Patriot?
Pat, you want to pull a name out of the bucket?
Absolutely.
And say it? Oh, guys, by the way, comedians, you know how it works. You get 60 seconds, everybody. We watch a comedian do 60 seconds, and then all of a sudden, they're just guests on a podcast with us. We can talk about anything in the world, usually find out more about them, cool stuff, anything, maybe stuff they could talk about in their stand-up, maybe not. Comedians, you know your time is up. Your 60 seconds when you hear the sound of a kitty. Oh, wow. You can really not hear that more than almost ever before. All the audio seems a little low. Let's hear it one more time. The sound of a kitty. There you go. Gets you a little bit every time. And wrap it up then or else you're going to bring out the angry West Hollywood bear. There you go. There you go. Okie dokie. Wow. Brian Redband showing how loud and good the sound can be. Once in a great while. Was that you on the guitar? Wow. Very good, Brian. Really filling in for Pat. Look at that. Picking up the extra slack. You guys ready to start tonight's show or what?
Let's do it.
Pat, pull a name out of the bucket and read it.
All right, the first name out of the bucket to do 60 seconds of stand-up is Johanna Petrie.
Hey.
So last time I came on here, I might have given some people the wrong impression because I was talking about big black cocks. That I only want a big dick, which is not true, because 3 inches is enough for me. Yeah, thank you. As long as it vibrates. Yeah, no, I love my vibrator. I do. I would marry it if it had a bank account. Seriously, I would take that thing with me everywhere. I'd be swiping it. We'd be having a great time shopping, dinners, vacations. Take it home, have a little orgasm, tuck it in bed, cuddle it all night. Right? I'm joking. I wouldn't cuddle it. I'd throw in a box with the other dildos and let them fight it out. Yeah. Like, yo, you think you're cool because you got a debit card? You're 3 inches long.
Oh, shit. Johanna Petrie, right? Fuck yeah.
Hello.
Johanna, what was that? What happened last time you were on? What'd you talk about?
We talked about Lexington Steel.
Oh, you had had sex with Lexington Steel. Yes. That's right. Okay. Yes.
At a group sex party.
Yeah.
And he said something that was over the line.
Oh, that's right. He was having sex with you. And what was it again that he said?
White bitch.
Oh, that's the line right there.
Yeah.
That's the line. Everybody knows when you're getting fucked by the actual Lexington Steel. The moment where you know this is going too far.
I like how we're still getting more juice out of her other set than this set.
Yeah, totally. Totally.
I think we can all collectively say red, white, and boo. You know what I'm saying?
Fuck yeah. There is something about the American flag bandana around your neck, by the way, that makes me feel like if you untied it, your head would just roll off.
Might.
You ever see that one ghost story where there's something like that? That one haunted book, scary stories?
There's a lot of American stuff going on up here.
Heck yeah, it is. Yeah. Anyway, I love your style, Jeremiah. Just when all else fails, just dress like a Best Buy employee.
Thank you so much, Tony.
You look like you served ice cream today or something.
Yeah.
So, Johanna, like, what did you do today on the 4th of July? How'd you spend your day?
I had a meeting this morning.
Meeting? How do you spell meet? You know what I mean? Was it another Lexington Steel meeting?
No, you know what I mean? No, it was a business meeting. They want me to sell this device.
They?
Well, this guy I know wants me to sell this medical device. It's like a thing called a TENS unit that gives you a shock. It's to reduce pain, but I heard you can also use it in S&M dungeon situations.
Boy. Oh, you heard that?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. It's did like they, max for the electrocuting sensation play. It's like the max level, I guess.
What is that?
It's Pat Reagan.
No, it's not. Anyway, Johanna, so yes. tell us something about you other than the fact that what else is interesting other than the fact that you've had sex with Lexington Steel?
Well, that's about it.
That was the most interesting. That
know.
Was the highlight.
How long have you been doing stand-up?
Like 4 years.
Four
actually,
years.
I just passed my four-year anniversary of stand-up.
Fuck
thank
yeah.
Thank you. And I specialize in dirty jokes. I did a show about a month ago at Flappers, and there was a 10-year-old kid in the front row for some reason.
And when you say
that was weird.
When you say flappers, you're talking about your pussy, right? Come on, she had sex with Lexington Steel. If you're ever gonna say a girl has a flappy pussy, now is the time. Trust me. Flappers, huh? I bet.
I bet her favorite Robin Williams movie is Flubber.
Flubber.
You know,
there you go.
Oh, man,
Thank you, Joel.
I tried to recycle a joke from a different show, and it didn't work, guys.
The Flubber reference. I did a show for super fans of the movie Flubber. And, Johanna, how do you make your money? You're obviously not selling any of these devices.
No, I'm not selling devices.
I have lots of meetings.
I can't talk about my money.
You can't talk about your money?
Yeah. secret sources of money.
When you Roses. Do you always laugh like the Crypt Keeper when you talk about it?
Maybe. I don't know.
Are you like a concubine for Sumner Redstone?
Whoa. I wish. That would be very rich. Viacom, right?
Yeah.
That
I
would
can
be
imagine
a good
him
one.
Having.
That would be a good one. Hey, so have you ever been with a man just for his money?
Yeah.
I think we're starting to find out the secret.
Yeah.
We're getting there, huh?
Is it like That's what my joke was about. Basically, if you have the choice, if the dildos are fighting and you have the little one with money or the big dick, you're going to go for the money.
Oh, I didn't get that at all.
Somehow it failed harder the second time.
Sorry.
Johanna. Interesting. So this, how long have you been with this guy?
No, I don't have any guy now. But I have had guys in the past.
Right. Mm.
Yeah. Huh. I'm like
I have had guys in the past.
Do you really have a box of dildos or are you exaggerating?
I do have a box of different types of sex toys.
Wow.
Box of cocks?
Box of cocks.
Classic.
Yeah.
That's what Pat calls it, the old box of cocks.
Yeah.
What else is in this box?
There's a the most interesting item I guess would be a pussy pump, which I saw in a movie a couple times where it pumps up the pussy like to make it
Yeah, I think
bigger.
I saw that movie too. What is that? Right? What was that one? Fast and the Furious 6?
Yeah.
Yeah, it makes you have a fat pussy so you could pump up like before a date or something.
Why do you want a fat...
Show up like a baboon.
The fat pussy horn, everybody. You've heard it before. You love it on the show. It's the fat pussy horn.
Wait, is that a thing?
Yeah.
It is. You got to look up pussy pump.
You blow it up?
Blow up your pussy.
It makes it look like a swole. Like it, it's like, it looks like turned inside out.
I thought Lexington Steel blew it out already for you. Oh, Jesus.
Why do these reputable ladies want fat pussies?
Yeah, what is there? Is there been a guy where it's like your pussy's too small?
No, I just want to try everything once, I guess. I saw it in a movie. It looked interesting.
What movie?
It's supposed to
watching?
Make it more sensitive because it has like the blood goes too closer to the
It
skin.
Makes it a lot bigger, for sure.
Did you like look in the mirror and stuff?
Oh yeah, it's like it turns into like a baboon, like a baboon.
Wow.
Oh my goodness.
Very racist.
Because that's what I've always wanted. Whenever I pull down a pair of panties, to be like, "What's the closest thing I can get to a baboon before I stick my dick inside of this?"
So did you hook up with the guy with the blown up thing?
Not really. No.
Not really.
Yeah, he saw the baboon pussy. And he's like, "No, thank you."
No.
When you say not really, how did that go? Yeah, yeah. Okay.
I just sent some pictures. That's it.
Okay. Brian, I don't know why you do this.
Do you want to see Jeremiah?
You just sent pictures. Brian's Where do you send pictures? To a
texting,
guy?
Just texting. Wow. Sexting.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, how does a guy respond to a picture of a blown up pussy?
They're like
that?
Come like, over and bring your pussy pump. Basically
they say that
yeah
I don't know I think I'd throw a couple emojis in there
peach
Johanna, what else? Tell us something else about you. Is all of your material sex
It's pretty
related?
Dirty. I can't think of anything clean that's also funny.
What else is in the box?
There's
multiple
like
things in the box, and the second thing you mentioned is a pussy pump. I want to know what number three is.
There's like a ball gag. There's like a huge black dildo named Bam. It had a picture of...
Wait a second.
Yeah.
You named it?
No, it had a name. I found the box. And it's a guy that looks like Tupac. And it's a big box. And it says Bam. But then I brought it home. It's like a baby size. You know?
It's a baby.
Yeah, but I thought, let me see this guy Bam in action. But it turns out he does gay porn. And
what the fuck?
And I didn't watch it. Yeah.
Johanna, you're like out of control. Your life is a mess. I love it.
I was hoping it was
dildo
like,
named Bam.
I was hoping it was like Bam Margera, and they're like, "Today on Jackass."
So Bam is the biggest. That was the one I was trying to impersonate, but I didn't want to be too racist. I thought, "Can I?"
I don't
be
know what would
racist
that sound
if
like
I'm a black
if
dildo.
You done it?
I don't know.
What color is Bam?
Dark brown. But and anatomically correct. It's supposed to be. It could not possibly be a life size.
It's dark brown. Yes. What color was it when you first got it?
That's a golden pony, y'all.
Anything else for Johanna, guys? Anything else? What do we? Anything else?
I'll try to think some clean thoughts for next time.
I don't think that's the problem. I think it's. I don't think it's about your cleanliness or your dirtiness. It's, you know.
I don't know. She's just oozing with sexuality. Yeah. She's just like, I'll try to think of some clean stuff the next time. I'll do what I can. But no promises.
It was so realistic that it was hard to get the funny out of, because we all just thought you were just telling us the truth about everything. Like, it just creeped.
You gotta
but the dildo with the debit card, that's not a real
thing. I feel like there's a really fucking, and I know I'm right about this, a really fucking, like, crazy human being behind those cold, dead eyes of yours.
Thank you.
And you need to, like, let it rip more. You're trying to, like, pretend like you're over the line and everything, but you're not. And you, instead of going for shock value, you need to, like, really break down what the fuck it is that you want to say.
Okay.
And don't be such a blown-up pussy about stand-up comedy. Just let it rip. Does that make sense?
I'll try. Yes. Thank you. All righty. Thanks.
I'm Johanna Petrie, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, I love this show. You never know who you're going to meet. Our second time ever with Johanna Petrie. First time you learned she had sex with Lexington Steel.
Hey, Tony.
Yeah.
Who dropped out on the show?
Nobody. Nobody. I literally wanted to celebrate our independence and just have fun. I decided not to even invite anyone.
That's pretty cool, yeah.
I mean, Ron White wasn't free this week, but, I mean, if he, you know, or else we would have done it some other 4th of July. And when it lands perfectly on a Monday.
Sorry, Tony, I can't make it here, man.
Ron, is that you?
Yeah, man, I just got lost in a whiskey bottle. Sorry.
He's the best.
Yeah, he's great.
He's going to come on
great
soon.
Great guy.
I just pulled another name out of the bucket. This is a guy that's been on the show many a times. Very funny. Always different. Put your hands together for Tam Fam, everybody.
Oh, yeah.
Hey. I've always been... All right, enough from you. I've always been self-conscious about my ears because kids are assholes. Most of them, anyway. One once told me that big ears add character. Then he said that it was a Disney character that's a flying elephant. I always got nicknames as a kid based on things that other kids said that I resembled. Dumbo because of the ears. Bruce Lee because he was Asian. Free Willy. Because the whale was naked and you still couldn't see his dick. Speaking of whale genitals, I like Japanese food, but I can't afford the good stuff. There's a Japanese restaurant I used to eat at all the time until I started paying attention and I noticed that the health department gave it a B, which is disgusting because I have never seen Asians get a B in anything.
Yeah, fuck yeah, Tam Fam. Oh, there's more. Finish it, Tam Fam.
Never seen Asians get a B in anything. Filipinos don't count. Okay.
Whoa.
Yo, dog, that was worth it.
Yo, just a quick diss on the Filipinos at the end. Man, someone.
Well, I like how he shushed you. He's like, I got to get this Filipino dig in before I'm freaking done with this set.
To just spew this pure hatred towards Filipinos. Tam Fam.
He really threw the Filipinos under the island.
There
you
it is.
That's my boy Patty Reagan right there.
Did you mean to have two Dumbo jokes kind of like in a row? Because it was kind of weird when you did it the second time.
Yeah, know? It's called a chunk, Brian.
Thought he was going to do a one-liner. Now, Tam Fam, let me ask you something. Last time you were on, we learned that Jeremiah can talk like you and you can move your lips.
It's true.
Somehow knowing where he's going to go.
He's better at being funny as me than I am at being funny as me. So.
Can you say that a little louder?
It's not going to work. Don't worry about it. What I said was important.
What?
Aw, Tam, can we get some more confidence in the monitors?
100 cc's. You say that Jeremiah is funnier at being you than you are, but I don't know. Should we put it to the test again?
Sure.
Let's do it.
So, Tam Fam, I'm just going to ask you a couple questions. First of all, welcome to another episode of Who's Talking? All right, Tam Fam, how's living in Los Angeles been going lately?
It's going pretty well.
Wait, you're not supposed to... Tam. Tam Fam, I think you forgot how this works. Welcome. We are back to Who's Talking? Tam Fam, how's living in Los Angeles been going?
Life is pretty good. But you know who I hate? Filipinos.
Boom. You know what? You are so right. Jeremiah is so much funnier being you. Let me ask you one more question. Tam Fam. What's your family situation like right now? You talk with them a lot?
Well, not very often. One would say I am the black sheep of my family.
Oh my God. Are you in on that on the camera? It's so fucking funny. He's so good at it. It's unbelievable. Oh my God. Tam Fam, what's been going on in your real life, though? Seriously. Go ahead, Tam Fam.
Not a lot.
Well, a lot of things.
Like what?
I have had sexual intercourse with many prostitutes. I say, is $20 enough? They slap me in the face and say, do I look like some kind of bitch prostitute whore to you?
It's so funny to me. I could watch like an hour of that straight. Dude, you guys could do something like crazy. You guys could be like the first ever like human ventriloquist comedian act. Oh, God. So, Tam Fam, in your real life, anything crazy been happening? Go ahead.
No, not at all.
Come on, something at all in your life. Did you almost get hit by a car? Were you late for work? How do you make your money again?
I'm an extra. I was working on the Muppets this one time. And,
as one of the Muppets?
Wow. Weird.
You have to see them for the podcast listeners.
When you work on the Muppets, they have a stage because the puppeteers are down below and all the Muppets are at top. And I was walking on the stage as an extra, right? And I forgot that there are holes all over the place, and I fell down as the first extra ever to fall in.
Wow. You had fall down music ready for that. Did you know where he was going there? So you fell down.
Yeah. So first extra ever to fall on the Muppets. So that's Forky.
It is an achievement that still disappoints my father to this day.
Tam Fam, you know when to turn it on. You have great comedic timing. Has anybody ever told you that before?
No.
Never.
Oh, shit. So what else in your real life? Have you? There was one part where I asked you and you said that you've had a lot of sexual intercourse lately. Is that true? Any of that?
I
did get wet on the regular. Sometime I wonder, can a dick get any wetter than this?
How wet does it get that it would be that wet?
So wet.
Oh my God. Oh my God. All right. Fuck. You guys want more of that or what? I mean, I really should move on, but maybe just a couple more questions. Tam Bam, let me ask you this on this special day. What is your favorite thing about the 4th of July?
My favorite thing about the 4th of July is probably the firework. Because at least somebody gets a bang.
I can hear you thinking. And when you hit it at the end, it's unbelievable. We're all rooting for both of you. It's unbelievable. I knew you had nothing. And then it ends with a bang. So beautiful. Jeremiah Watkins, ladies and gentlemen.
Tam Fam, everybody.
I call Jeremiah the article because he's a part of every single funny show in this town. The stand up on the spot, his show, Thunder Pussy, the improvised stand-up show, Roast Battle, Goddamn Comedy Jam, and Kill Tony. Jeremiah Watkins, a freak of nature. Doesn't get enough credit. Should already be on SNL. We're lucky to have him, as you could tell by his Tam Fam impression. SNL has been in demand of somebody that can do... Tam Fam, did you know you were that famous?
Yes, I did. Because... I never bite off more than I can chew.
Wow. This is really, I sort of hate it and love it, but this is like the podcast, it's become the podcast that you have to watch, you know what I mean? The listeners, I mean, they're just like listening to us crack up about God only knows what. Like, what's so funny about his dick getting wet while we're just dying for 30 seconds? All right, Tam Fam, I'm going to let you go. Right. There he goes, Tam Fam, everybody. He's on Twitter at Tam Fam Comedy. Jonna Petrie, by the way, I'm sure a lot of our fans want to know. She's on at Wild Joe Comedy, J-O, that's it. And Tam Fam's at Tam Fam Comedy, P-H-A-M. Fuck yeah, one more time for Tam Fam, everybody. Oh my God. Oh my God, that's the funniest fucking thing. That's its own fucking show. This is a funny guy that's been on a couple times. Put your hands together for him. Brian Vokey, everybody.
I can't wear a new pair of pants for less than a half hour without blowing out the crotch. Which wouldn't be a problem, except I don't have the kind of job where my dick can be out all day. I'm a preschool teacher. It's disrespectful as fuck to have your dick out in a classroom setting. Like the other day, I was going to read a kid's Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs. You know that story? I sit down, I was going to read him that, and as I sat down, my pants ripped open. And because I'm thick, I got to apply baby powder in the morning. So when my pants ripped, a plume of smoke came out of my crotch like my dick was a trick cigar. I had to say something. I had to address it. So I was like, more like Cloudy with a Chance of My Balls. Right, kids? I don't know where I'm at there. I'm good.
Giving up at 52 seconds. Brian, I'm pretty sure you did that joke on this show before,
no,
right?
No.
I'm pretty sure you
Okay. I've done it at the potluck and you were there.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I was?
Yep.
Wow. That's a random.
I hate that I know that.
Yeah. Yeah.
but that I didn't. Makes sense. I'd rather
Tony,
clear it up.
You matter so much to me.
Well, every once in a while I sit in for just a second, see what the fuck's going on in there. Okay, that makes sense. Brian, you look like every member of the Addams Family put together. All of them. Has anyone ever told you that
Tony,
before?
I'm pretty sure you used that joke on the show before.
Oh, okay. Oh. Again, on you, right?
Yeah,
exactly. I mean, sorry to repeat a great joke about you. But maybe you should be opening with it.
Is your crotch really busted?
Yeah, he's seen me do it at an open mic, actually.
Why?
Yeah.
Why?
Yeah.
Wait, what happened?
My pants are just, I don't know, I'm thick. You know, I got cakes.
So am I. But, you know, do you buy, like, off jeans?
I buy cheap. You know, used jeans.
What kind of cakes do you have?
Cakes. Yeah. Red velvet, baby.
He said, I'm thick, I got cakes.
When you say blow out the crotch, what does that mean?
Like, okay, when you're fat, this is a problem you've never had. When you, like, crouch down, like, it
never
rips. It just rips out.
Never had that happen. I have the thickest thighs in this business.
A bunch of cakes.
I've
never had that happen. Though.
Print that T-shirt now, Death Squad.
You're next to me and coming to the stage.
Thickest thighs in comedy. Definitely got the thickest lies in comedy. That's not true.
I know, I've never
done really
that.
Owned it there. Like, you were really owning those thighs.
You've thought
you
that before.
What? That's never happened to me. I have the biggest thighs. You realized after you said it what you had said.
It's like you say that in the mirror every morning.
Yeah, biggest thighs in comedy, Brian Redman.
Beautiful.
New Twitter bio. biggest thighs in comedy. All right. What do you mean you blow out the guy? What are you doing, squats and jeans? Like, what's happening?
Well, first of all, preschool furniture is like Guantanamo Bay interrogation furniture. It's like this big, right. So you got to get low.
I cannot believe you're a preschool teacher. How long have you been doing
this
for?
Well, I got fired.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, that makes sense.
It's an old joke.
Oh. Oh,
it's not that old.
What'd they fire you for? And why do I get the feeling that you still peek through the windows sometimes at the old gig? What'd they fire you for? Oh, shit. We're not getting the truth on this one.
No. I've been arrested for shoplifting, and they renewed my FBI background check, and shoplifting got me fired.
The classic tale.
Brian, I'm going to ask you a question, and I want to see how you are at being TamFam while... I want to see if you're a better TamFam physically than TamFam, but with TamFam's voice.
So sure.
I'm going to ask you a question.
Sure. Sounds good.
Do I have to do TamFam's voice, or can I do a different voice?
I was hoping it would be TamFam's voice.
Okay. We'll try it.
I just want to see what it looks like.
Sure.
Mm-hmm. So, Brian.
Why is that still
Jesus Christ?
That doesn't even make any sense at this moment.
Slavery, huh?
Yeah. It's every week it gets at a weirder, stranger time. Okay, so Brian, how'd you get here today? What's your favorite form of transportation around Los Angeles?
Well, of course, it has to be a scooter.
Oh yeah, you're pretty bad at this.
Yeah.
Why?
Can I do a different?
I'm not
voice?
An immigrant.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, Brian, let me ask you a question. Yeah.
Oh, what's up?
What's the creepiest job you ever had?
Well, one time, I was, oh man, God, I was digging graves, and I had a handler with me, and I said, pass me the shovel, pass me that shovel. What was the question?
Drop the mic on that one.
It's really hard to follow puking in an impression is what I just learned.
Yeah.
He won't give up. When it's one of the only two songs you know on saxophone, you just let him play it. Fuck yeah. So Brian...
What's up?
Brian, in real life, tell us something interesting about you. You have any special skills, anything like that? Master yo-yo artist, like to skydive?
No, I'm a musician. I used to tour a lot in bands. A lot.
What band?
I got three bands on Spotify.
Really?
Yeah. Ooh,
what are their names?
Cold Beat, Neon Piss.
Wait. Slow down. What was the first one?
Cold Beat.
Cold Beat. Okay, so you tried to take like a couple cool names and put them together there. All right, what's the second one?
Neon Piss.
I feel like I'd actually like that band. What's the third?
And the New Flesh.
Oof.
It's a Cronenberg reference.
It's a what?
Cronenberg.
I don't even know what that means.
As I said, I was digging graves.
Wow, that's cool. What's your instrument?
All of them. Guitar, bass, drums.
Now,
all
normally,
the rock bands
Pat gets very, very angry at other people that do music and comedy. Pat, what do you think about... Do you have any questions for Brian?
I like Brian's vibe. I like his attitude. I like talking to him.
Yeah.
How That's good for a podcast.
Where are you from?
Atlanta, Georgia.
How long have you been in L.A.?
Just 6 months. I lived in the Bay. Came here from. That's where I started comedy, is the Bay.
Which Bay?
Oakland.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. So you've been here for 6 months.
Yeah.
Anything fun happen in those 6 months? What isn't a thing in L.A. that you thought would be? Or something like that?
I don't know. I live in like a... you know, hiking, swimming, shit like that. Shit I can't do in the Bay, you know?
Do you think people, like... Did you have audiences when you played shows that, like, went wild? Or what is it? Is everyone just tame and on their phones?
No, people would shoot firecrackers at us, throw chairs, all that shit. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, it was fun.
Half-lit sparklers?
No, real fireworks. Real fireworks.
Oh, wow. Cool.
We played in Budapest one time, and I got ripped off the stage, and they destroyed my bass.
What does ripped off the stage mean?
Like, literally grabbed by my clothes and pulled down, and all my bass just destroyed.
It sounds like they loved it.
While that was happening, where you're like, I'm doing it.
No, it was more like, just breathe.
Budapest is great. You ever go to the baths and get your ass slapped around a little bit?
No, I was there being a successful musician.
Whoa. This boy's got some snark.
So you were a very successful musician, huh?
I mean, I paid my rent off it.
That's incredible. And you gave it up to chase your dream of being a stand-up comedian?
Yeah, it got boring after a while. It's just like the same shit over and over and over again. You know, I get bored. I have to do new stuff all the time.
So you didn't write a lot of new stuff? Did you write your own songs?
Yeah, yeah.
But you just got sick of writing?
Yeah, it's just, I mean, just sitting in a van all the time, just driving 8 hours, 10 hours, just constantly hungover. And it got boring.
Eating shitty food.
Just, yeah, McDonald's, Taco Bell.
Oof. Jesus.
Just, yeah.
What's one of your bands that, or an album we should check out on Spotify?
I would check out Neon Piss, Neon Piss.
The self-debuted
Neon Piss by Neon Piss, featuring hit song
album Neon Piss. Here it is. Here's a little Neon Piss. Brian's brought it up. Is that you?
On the guitar.
Piss is your neon. By the way, this is a different song. He just hit a button for a different song. It sounds like the same song. Hit another button. Maybe it just. There you go. This is Santana, right? Another one?
Poor guys.
Oh, shit. That's you.
Yeah.
It was the summer.
Does anybody else feel like they're playing Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 2?
I'll sing Neon Piss. Can I get him to sing some Neon Piss?
Awesome.
Yeah, I do want to say our guitar player died last week. So,
whoa.
R.I.P. to Barker G.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Why does that get an applause break? Good.
I get it. It's weird to deal with that feeling.
Man. Yeah.
R.I.P. Barker G.
Damn. Yeah. Neon. Hopefully they can get him some neon embalming fluid. You know what I mean?
Oh, man.
How did he die? Overdose? No?
No.
Hit by a...
Suicide.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah.
Oh God, I'm sorry to hear that. Were you guys close?
Yeah, very close.
Holy shnikes.
Yeah. It was funny because I just seen like 10 comics do, I'm gonna kill myself after the set goes bad.
Right.
Like in the last week, and I'm like, no, you're not, you fucking pussy.
That's funny. That's really funny.
Yeah. I'm so sick of that. Like, oh, this joke sucks, so here's my easy way out.
Right. There you go.
Yeah.
Brian uses it every week. Man, do you want to talk about it? Or
I'm good, man. I'm good. I've processed.
How did he do it?
The sample. It just happened.
Really?
Yeah.
One shot, huh?
Tony Hinchcliffe special on Netflix.
That's right. One shot. One shot, but your
body's not cold.
I love it. No, it never is. Wow. What kind of gun? Do you know what kind of gun he is?
22.
Did he do it anywhere weird?
Arkansas? That's
Arkansas,
weird.
Arkansas, fuck yeah. That's a yes. You can check the yes box on that one.
I thought you meant that like, he shoot his dick or something like that.
Some people do get weird at the last second. They like fuck it up, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah. Then they got a weird face for the rest of their life.
Fuck, right. Man.
Next up on Bringing Down the Room.
No, I like it.
It's fine, man. Life
Which
shit.
Had he been, was he done with music? Was he done playing music at that point?
He definitely is done playing music, Pat.
Yeah, right before he killed himself?
No, he was in bands. Yeah, he was in bands.
Were any bands cooler than Neon Piss?
Yeah, all his bands. Yeah, I mean, the dude graduated from Berklee College of Music with a degree in guitar. He's like a master.
How'd he end up in Arkansas?
That's where he's from.
Yikes. Yeah,
I used to go to this great rib place in Arkansas.
Yeah,
and then I asked a girl from Arkansas. I was like, "Hey, is Bubba's still open?" She's like, "No, Bubba's hasn't been open in years. They shut it down. They were selling meth straight out of the kitchen."
I was like, "Is that why the ribs were so good for all those years?" Yeah, those weren't ribs, dude. That was the lead singer in Neon Piss, bro. They're just serving
his
them up.
Methy ribs. It's not a lot of meat on methy ribs.
Man, that sucks. So you going to Arkansas for the funeral?
I just went up to the Bay for a thing. There was a thing in the Bay. Cool. I just got back yesterday.
That's good. That's good.
It's fine.
My
I don't
heart
know
is
all
racing
of you are
going
right to die.
Now.
It's okay. Relax.
My heart is beating so fast. Right
really?
Now. Oh, yeah.
Really? Wish we could say the same for Brian's friend. Guys, come on. Come on. He's clapping. You should be laughing.
It's fine.
That's so cool that you have a good sense of humor. That must help get you through shit.
Yeah, well, what am I going to do?
That thing about now you hear other people talk about killing themselves is really funny. Any other bright sides to this suicide that happened?
You know, coming to L.A. to do comedy, to do it every night at the mics and stuff, you forget that you have friends
right.
that have nothing to do with comedy. And this kind of got me back in touch with a bunch of people. And that's and it's so important to hang out with people who aren't awful.
Totally. Totally. Absolutely.
Yeah.
I completely
it's true.
Agree.
It's very true.
And that's beautiful and well put. And I love that.
Yeah.
Brian
Boelke,
ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
There he goes,
yeah.
Brian Boelke. Yeah. Turned into a likable character by the end of that interview.
It's on Twitter at Brian Boelke. That's Brian with a Y. And Boelke, V-O-K-E-Y. We're just moving along.
Wow, they pulled his chair out from underneath him. Right after this is that's how hard it is to make friends in comedy, by the way. They just heard that your friend just killed himself.
To add insult to suicide.
And then he commented
that he was connecting with people.
Oh, no, Mike.
Awful.
What was that?
He's moment has passed. Never mind.
My only regret was that when your mic wasn't working, if Tam Fam would have done your voice for you from over there. I pulled a name out of the bucket. This looks like a new name. I'm not positive. I'm sorry if I'm insulting you by not remembering you. But here we go. Zachary Stein, everybody.
Thank you. I still use a pot dealer. I fucking hate him. He's the worst person I know. Like, the best example of this is he'll text me, or he'll, like, tell me about, like, he'll brag about going to the strip club and paying for a blowjob. Which, don't get me wrong, I think that's a great thing to do. I paid for a blowjob. I paid for multiple blowjobs. And shit, if I had a nickel for every time I paid for a blowjob, I would have like an unsustainable business model. Like, what annoys me is he's bragging about it, you know? It's like you partook in commerce. You pay for a service. I've never been like, yo, I went to Denny's the other day. I gave them money. They brought me food. They cleaned it up. I run that bitch. It's ridiculous. So I like text him, and he makes me use code words for pot. So I do now. Like, I'll be like, hey, friend. That one's a code word. Hey, friend, I need half an ounce of child pornography. Or, hey, that's all for me, guys. Thank you very much. My name's Zach Stein.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah.
I like that closeout. Zach, for some reason, I feel like you just woke up hungover, started drinking again, and then came here, signed up, and just performed. How close am I to right on that?
Fucking ridiculously right. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah,
I nailed it?
Yeah.
You seem like you're like half awake, half drunk. Special like 4th of July just blowout. Like, well, if they pick my name, whatever happens, happens. Like that. I'm going to try to do some jokes if they don't laugh, whatever. If they do, it's great. I mean, we're just going to do it tonight.
It's nice that you thought it was holiday specific.
I love that. You drink a lot all the time, huh?
Like, I mean, I
get
sober for
work. You're like
Chris
Farley without the swagger. Without the jokes, too. Zach, you have a name like Zachary Stein. Now, yeah. We remember you from last episode.
Oh, yeah. Dude.
I'm
trying not to look at it.
Speaking
I've already
episode where we've
it.
Already talked about blowing out crotches, Zachary Stein, for those of you that missed it, you were on probably a couple months ago, something like that.
Yeah.
And the thing about him was that you could see when we ended up talking in extent about your giant penis, right?
Yeah. That is correct.
And you still have that hog's leg, huh? How's that working out for you?
About the same, yeah.
Wow. My God.
It sounds like all same the blood is in his other head.
Yeah. I feel like, did someone wire your jaw before this set? You know, it's there and it's doing really good. My goodness. I love it. What did you drink today? I feel like it started with tomato juice for some reason.
I just drank a bunch of dicks. Couple King Cobra 40s and then.
Whoa. My God.
Dude.
Fucking the wolf of Martin Luther King Boulevard over here.
This fucking dick's a King Cobra 40.
Yeah. Oh, if this place was packed, it'd be crazy for that one. Said everybody's wondering if it's as funny as they think it is. Yeah.
Tony, it looks like he's smuggling a Renaissance Fair turkey leg in his pants.
It really is aggressive, even in these pants. And I think I remember last time it was like gray
different
pants or something
pants,
like that.
Yeah.
It was like a fucking like.
Oh yeah.
It was a situation.
And of all the people that tucks in his shirts, you're one of the guys that doesn't. That always has his shirt tucked in.
Yeah.
Why? You need to start wearing baggy clothes. I mean,
why do I feel like you have a couple tiny little airport liquor bottles on you right now? Am I right?
Hey.
I'm getting that vibe, but you don't, right? Do you have a flask on you?
I don't think that far ahead, but like maybe in the future I will. That's a good idea.
Jesus, thank you. I love that. I'm sure you'll remember that, by the way.
I'm not blackout yet. It would be way fucking worse. But...
I like how
I'll remember this conversation. Yeah.
He still managed to put a full suit on, though.
Yeah,
that's crazy.
He looks
to
so
me.
Together,
right?
Yeah, no,
that's what happens when you only own clothes like that. There's just no other options. I'm sure that if he had sweatpants and a T-shirt, he'd be wearing it right now.
Yeah, this is the
Did
worst.
Did you sleep? You slept in that outfit? Am I correct?
No. Maybe a week
what
ago.
What do you consider sleep? Like a long nap?
I laid on my belly in the park, but who gives a fuck about that? Depends on me. Were my eyes closed? Maybe. Maybe they weren't. Since I've done laundry,
you know,
probably.
It's just another day. It's not even July 4th to me. Fuck yeah. I always wondered how you celebrate July 4th since the first time
disease,
I saw you
man.
Was in a Christmas story. Yeah.
I'm not even wearing my glasses today. You did that last time.
Sure, people. Again.
Oh,
again.
Shit.
If you look exactly fucking like somebody, you're going to get hit with the same fucking joke, you morons. Welcome to comedy, you fucking buffoons. You called me that last time. Yeah. You look like you'll shoot your eye out.
You don't poop.
Yeah.
So I made the call twice.
Good call.
Son of a bitch.
And he didn't call you a buffoon last time.
Yeah.
I'll tell you that much.
Buffoon.
I'll tell you that much. He did not call you that
buffoon.
Last time. Because that is a brand new word I've never heard of.
It's
you
my
buffoon.
New favorite. It's my new favorite. And you're going to hear a lot of that. I might be releasing the new buffoon t-shirt. The bumper sticker.
Hashtag buffoon, people.
Zachary, tell us something about your real life that's happened lately, and maybe something about, you know, living life drunk. You know, what's that like?
I get sober. I work like a normal day job and
like
shit.
Like what?
I manage a hair salon in Santa Monica.
Huh. Girl.
How does that go for you?
Good. Like I'm good at it and stuff, but...
there it is.
I can, like, it doesn't... Because I know, like, that money is allowing me to get fucked up on a regular basis and stuff. So I can be in the moment and, like, be good at my job because I know I can't get that fucked up. I just have to go crazy if I don't have a job.
Jesus, so. I feel like it's never going to end. You know, I just keep getting fucked up and I work and then I get fucked up some more and then all of a sudden I'm working again and then I get fucked up and then all of a sudden I'm like, I need more money, might as well work more and then all of a sudden I'm like all drunk and then I wake up and I'm like, I need to go to work and I'm drunk and everybody's not dead and then I fall asleep and then I wake up again and I'm like, I gotta work.
I have a problem.
I'm only here to try to get some mangria.
What?
I said I'm only here to try to get some mangria.
It looks like you have a bottle in your pants right now, Zachary.
This isn't the commercial. New from mangria. Straight out of the crotch. A hand bust through.
Available at Santa Monica Hair Salons. How long you worked at the salon?
I've been in the salon industry for like 7 years.
What? What is? You say that like it's hilarious.
It's, people don't expect it, I guess.
What goes on there that we wouldn't know about? Is that true? Is it raining men?
There's a lot of like gay people, if that's what you mean, yeah. A lot of gay men cut hair.
Why? Oh my god. Craziest thing you've ever had go down in your salon while managing. What was that?
Dick.
Any problems or anything?
I mean, yeah, just people trying to fucking get their money back and stuff, and I'm good at telling them no. And
what do you say when somebody's like, I want my money back?
Listen, I need my money back stat. This isn't looking good at all.
Okay. No, that's not what I say. But
for your haircut, Jeremiah, he might actually give you the money back.
Yeah.
That one's gonna fuck with Jeremiah because he loves his hair so much.
Oh, dude.
As you could tell, he curls the edges out every night before.
No, I don't, you bafu.
Oh shit, Zachary, what are your parents like? Do they like what you do? Do they know you?
Yeah,
do they love you?
Like my dad's a big fan. My mom's like
a big fan.
Yeah, he likes my stand-up and shit.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah.
How long have you been on stand-up?
About 5 years.
Wow.
Yeah, like 4 years.
What's your mom like?
She's like a like old racist Arab lady.
What?
Yeah.
Old racist Arab lady?
Yeah.
And you came out of her vagina?
No, I had a surrogate mother.
Bah, bah, bah.
Right?
Surrogate mother! Bah, 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 bah.
What is
raised that? By one mom, actually from a different mom. Bah, 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 bah.
Wow. So, how do you think that affected you?
Probably a good amount, man. She's
How Arab is she? Arab?
Oh no, my mom.
How Arab is she?
Welcome to another episode of How Arab Is She?
She's so Arab.
On a scale from 9 to 11, or 7 to 11. How Arab is she? 11 or 9?
11.
Or she, 7.
11. 7, 9, 11.
9, 11?
She had an arranged marriage at like 15.
15.
That's really 16. The joke. If I could, if we edit this, it would be on a scale from 7, 11 to 9, 11. How Arab is she? So good when you actually figure it out. Takes that extra second. Writer's Guild. So Zachary, real life shit. Anything else? I mean, how Arab is she?
She fucking had a arranged marriage at 15 and her first kid at 16, so pretty Arab.
Are you the first kid?
No, my dad's her third marriage. He's a Jew.
Yeah, we... There's the classic Jew yodel we've heard on this show so many times. Interesting. So the Jew and the Arab lady.
Yeah, so my
huh?
oldest
That's
brother's
rare.
Like fucking 55.
What?
My oldest brother's like 55.
Fuck yeah. What's he like? Are they all like you?
He's a little like me. He's fucked up. He's like, he has triplets, but he...
You do a lot
he
of...
He loves Donald Trump and
shit. You do drugs?
Yeah, what's occasionally.
What are your favorite drugs to do?
Mushrooms, and then second, I guess, would be pot. Coke, third.
I love that creepy heroin smile you give after coke, third, like... It's first if you have any.
DMT fifth.
Zachary, anything else for Zachary, guys? What do you guys think?
I don't think so, man. I think
Zachary,
we covered it.
All this, I can't remember what we figured out last time. Did we ask you how big your dick actually is?
You did not.
How big is it? Have you measured it before?
Like, not in a few years. I don't own a ruler anymore. But,
It outgrew the ruler.
Yeah. It's been years since I could capture it with a ruler.
He used to mark it at his old childhood home.
just Clamato puke all over the wall.
Very competitive household. And
what's your favorite thing to drink when you're not? I mean, it seems like someone who's drinking 40 ounces of King Cobras is on a budget. Am I correct?
I don't need to be. I just like to.
Thrifty. It's like Jew party.
I make good money and everything, but I don't. I don't know.
Do you know who? Did your dad fuck somebody else?
I believe so.
Wow. Do you know who that is?
Like this Norwegian lady I saw on Facebook. She's fat and shit. But.
Wait! Wow! That's how you talk about your real mom? I saw this piece of shit on Facebook. She's kind of fat.
She had like 2 likes.
I would have met her if she was like a good-looking person. I saw something in my future, but I was like, oh, that's why I just got this fucking gut. And I bet she was probably pretty when he fucked her, because why not? But
wow! Way to go, Dad!
Oh my goodness! Wow!
How big's your dick?
It's like 7 inches, you know, and then but it's girthy. I got like some good width, and I
was that the thing was that it? What do I remember about this episode? Something crazy.
Oh wow,
he's girthy, man. Width hooks to the left. Remember,
yeah. Zachary? Anything else? There you go, buddy. Zachary Stein.
Oh,
there he goes.
I got one.
No jokes.
No, it's not a joke.
Okay, what?
If you follow me on Instagram, Stein Feet and Toes, I'm trying to be the number one Jewish foot fetish Instagram account in the world.
Wait a second.
Wait, you buried that?
After I'm trying to find something interesting about him for 10 minutes, he goes, by the way, yo, follow me on Instagram, trying to set a record for foot fetish shit. Goodbye. Yeah.
Jewish foot fetish.
What the fuck are you talking about? Jewish foot fetish?
Yeah, I think feet are
gross.
Oh my
God, what's so special about Jewish feet? What do they have, pennies in between the toes?
There you go.
Oh my God.
Wait, do you
this
like.
This is by the way, for those of you that wonder, why is Tony taking such a podcast way into show business? It's because I make jokes like that and I don't have a choice. Jewish people hate me. Just kidding. Zachary, what is it about Jewish women's feet?
No, it's my feet.
What?
It's my feet. I think feet are gross, but I just think there's like a misrepresentation. There's a lack of representation of Jewish feet in the industry.
Wait, you photograph your own feet and put them on Instagram.
Because of the lack of representation.
Yeah, I'm trying to,
Well, we got to see your freaking feet now.
Is there anything special about your feet? Oh, this is a bad idea. Oh, God. Okay, dude, this is the...
Oh, I should ask to see the dick.
I can smell the matzah. Put it away.
Zachary Stein. So how many Instagram followers do you have on
not
this?
Not a lot.
How many?
Not a lot.
So it's a work in progress.
When's the last time you vomited?
Fucking, I don't know, like 5 days ago.
Really?
Fuck yeah.
What were you drinking that night? Do you remember?
I think I actually had some tequila that night, which said, yeah, whatever.
Yeah, fuck yeah.
Hard liquor.
Why aren't Jewish feet represented? How did you get that idea into your mind?
Like, I mean, if you look at the fucking top foot fetishists, like, there's very few...
Do you look at a lot of men's feet?
No, but there's just... I just know there's very few Rosenblatts in that industry.
In what? In the male foot?
Gender is not important in this issue.
So you're representing for all Jewish feet.
Yeah, like, I wish a woman had the courage to take the foothold, but because I think that would be more widely embraced. But like, I see where I'm needed, and I do my part.
Do you have your toes in your mouth right now?
Ooh. Where did that come from?
Is that Joel?
Cool.
I was waiting for my opportunity.
Joel Jimenez over there. Buddy.
And you got it.
Zachary, I love it that you're looking at your watch. This like you're actually
my friends are comics. I don't want to take up too much time.
Fuck yeah.
I'll manage you, dude.
Thank you, man.
Can I get 10% of your dick?
He's so proud of that. Stuck the tongue out like Jordan after he nailed it. Zachary Stein, everybody. There he goes. He's on Twitter at @hack_Stein. @hack_Stein. How about that? Jeremiah? Fuck yeah. The Stink Panther. There he goes. Zachary Stein. Oh, we've had this guy on the show once before from Arizona. Put your hands together for Anthony Decimito.
Hey,
Hi. So if you're a fat guy and you're not wearing a funny shirt, you are just wasting everybody's time. You're giving us 50%, guys. I like my jizz like I like my economics. Trickle down. All the way down to the ground. Because that's where my face is. I feel like I look like one of those people at the end of that show, Catfish. You know, the ones that come out of that double white trailer at the end? And the two guys are like, hey, we're looking for Jessica. And I'm like, I'm fucking Jessica, bitch. Me and McKay are in love. 5 years.
Boom. Anthony Decimito. So funny. Am I saying that right? Decimito?
Yeah, you are.
So funny. Man, you love pussy, don't you?
Yes. Man pussy. That.
There you go. How's July 4th gone for you? Anything special today?
Not really. Just cleaned my bathroom.
Fuck yeah. That must take hours.
A lot of jizz on the floor.
So many hours.
Lots of jizz.
Clean with your tongue.
Fuck yeah. So, Anthony, that's fun. Another fun minute. You're hilarious. You killed last time you were on. You did it again.
Oh, thank you.
Tell us something else interesting about you in real life. Do you live in LA now?
Yeah, I've been here for about a month now.
Cool.
So,
how's that going for you?
Still unemployed. So, trying to figure.
Where are you looking for a job at? I know a guy that manages a hair salon. He's probably totally. Oh,
what's
God,
up?
There he is, swigging. Swigging the bottom remnants of a Pabst Blue Ribbon. The timing, finally. He's nailing his timing up there. Well lit up.
I can do a mean faux hawk.
Is that true? Do you, Anthony, what kind of job are you looking for?
I'm looking for a video editing job. Mm-hmm. That's what I did back in Arizona.
Oh, video editing.
And I also serve tables. So.
Oh, wow. What kind of tables? Where have you waited tables at before?
I worked at Cracker Barrel.
Oh,
yeah. They must have hated you there. Yeah.
They did.
That restaurant is racist.
I worked there.
Hey, what can I get for you? What the hell? I just want some damn biscuits and gravy. Got queers coming over my table. What's going on here? This is Cracker Barrel. This is United States of America. Happy 4th of July, bitch.
They didn't realize I was gay until way later. And then they fired me.
Wow. Oh, Jesus. Wow.
Wait, were you like a good employee and they like found a reason to fire you?
Yeah, I know. Like they got to like.
We have the same thing. I like picture you getting fired from Cracker Barrel for like being, you know, doggy style on a rocking chair.
Yeah, or breaking too many rocking chairs. We're going to fire you for breaking too many rocking chairs, not because you're gay.
Why did they fire you? Because how did they find out you were gay? Started blowing the peppermint?
Well, they had like a...
Where's all the peppermills?
Well, like, I transferred over to the one in Mesa, Arizona, and they did not like me.
Whoa.
At all.
Mesa, Arizona doesn't even like Mexicans, and you have a lot going for you.
Yeah.
Right?
Right.
What is your nationality, Anthony? Mexican?
I am Mexican and Filipino.
Decimito sounds sort of Italian, no?
It sounds Italian, but it's Filipino. Mm-hmm. It's like the name of some bird or something in the Philippines.
Some gay bird.
Some gay bird.
What else? What else you been doing for a month? Are you living in West Hollywood? Because the difference, I'd imagine. I don't know much, but I'd imagine that the difference in, you know, being able to be a gay man in West Hollywood compared to Arizona. Night
yeah,
and day.
I'm definitely less special out here. Like over there, it was like, whoa, gay guy.
Right.
That's not dead. That's great.
Wow, what a negative way to look at it. Well, I'm less special now that there's other gays here.
Yeah. Right. I was a luxury guy.
You were just a fucking Arizona dump truck before. And now you come out here. I don't know.
I'm still.
How's it been going? Have you hooked up with anybody? And if so, where and how?
I've not hooked up with anybody. I thought I was, but then the guy was like we kissed, and then he was like, I hope I'm not giving you the wrong message, but I don't want to be with you. And I was like, then why did you kiss me? And then I left his house.
Oh boy, there was no real. Okay. There was no none of that like tam fam twist at the end.
No.
And then we went out with a bang. It's like what? Oh, nothing.
I imagine.
And then I fucked a homeless guy.
Whoa! Wow! Really?
No. There's a punchline. I imagine.
I wish.
That's like whenever you're at the grocery store and you take a sample from one of those people and then they're like, so are you going to buy it? And you're like, you must not understand what our relationship is. I'm taking this for free and walking away from you.
So you fucked a homeless guy, huh? What's that like? Is that like on news?
Wait, that's a that real
on,
thing?
On newspapers or something like that?
No, okay. One time... I went on a date with a homeless guy, but I didn't know he was homeless
at
the time.
Let me guess. You guys went on a walk in the park?
We're going to go to this new restaurant. It's called Bench. Period.
It's a really hip place. It's just a bench, and you have to... Very exclusive. Very exclusive.
But
how'd the date... What did you do on the date with the homeless guy?
We went to a punk show. I was like, okay, well...
Jeremiah's
we should
face.
Just go, like, I was like, oh, maybe a mosh pit scenario would keep us from talking to each other.
And how was Neon Piss?
I broke a guy's guitar. That was a callback.
Well, Anthony, you are funny as fuck. I'm rooting for you big time. Hopefully you find a day job soon, make some money while getting to tell funny jokes tonight and getting to meet everybody and know everybody. But you are absolutely hilarious. And
thank you.
Thanks for being on the show again. There he goes, Anthony DeSimito, everybody. He's on Twitter at Anthony DeSimito. Let's get our two regulars up here and see if we have time for another one at the very end. Going up first tonight, you know her, you love her. She started as a nervous, shaking puppy and slowly has gotten more and more calm. Writing and performing a brand new minute every... Are either one of them here? Either one?
I don't think
she's here. Oh, wow, okay. You know the other regular? Super confident, super swag. The one, the only, Vanessa Johnston, everybody.
I don't identify as a Republican or a Democrat. I'm an atheist. Yeah, fuck that joke. So stupid. I don't know though. Like, how are you proud to identify as an elephant or a donkey? Like, those are the lamest animals. Like, elephants are fat, hairy, nearly extinct, and so are most Republicans. But Democrats are stubborn asses. So annoying. According to studies, the registered voting population is 20% Republican, 30% Democrat, 40% Independent, and the remaining percentage are like, where's George Washington? Like, fuck all these guys. What sucks is that registered independents, the majority of the population, are not allowed to vote. Okay.
Fuck yeah. Your senior Daily Show correspondent, yeah. Vanessa Johnston.
So gross.
She is live on the scene.
No.
Fuck yeah. You were so quick to hate on your own opening joke.
I know.
I don't even think you gave it a chance to really breathe.
Maybe.
Anyway, how's life? What's happening?
It's good. I was in a bikini all weekend.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
July
4th. I'm still in a bikini.
Wait, what?
So is Jeremiah, actually, underneath all that, strangely enough. What is this, by the way? Why are you dressed like... What are you? You're so funny, Pat. You're so cool, dude. You're like the hippest guy I know. You seem like you'd be like the most fun... person at a party.
Ooh. He's pretty fun, Tony.
He is? I don't know what it's like to have real friendship. I don't have that with anybody. Fun fact, you'd think I'd have a lot, but no one. Cold to everyone at the end of the day. Ask Brian, he knows.
Inside the mind of the golden pony.
It's not true.
Vanessa, what's the most fun thing that happened when you're hanging out in a bikini this
Tony
weekend?
Thought he had a lot of friends.
Oh.
I don't know.
But he had another thing coming.
I want to hear the rest of this trailer. If that's the beginning, then what happens next? Tam Pam? What'd you see crazy? Anything crazy happen at the beach? I don't ever get to make it out there, ever.
Really?
Ever. I never, ever do. Even when I want to, I just don't even end up, like, really walking out to the ocean.
Nobody ever invited Tony Hinchcliffe to the beach.
I totally forgot we were just doing that before. Like, I totally set myself up. I'm like, okay, we'll move on. He's not going to do more of that. God, even when I'm not trying, I lead the show in a perfect direction. Anything?
I mean, no, not really. It's the beach, you know.
Pretty mellow. I don't even know what goes on there.
It was weird, like...
Did you get in the water?
Huh? Yeah.
That's a thing. I did that once. It's like freezing cold.
Yeah.
It's like so uncomfortable.
He was invited to the beach once, but never invited back again because he kept complaining.
Maybe that's what it is. The water was cold, like his friendships. All right. Vanessa, we'll rock and roll. Writing and performing a new minute
Thanks,
every
guys.
Single week's hard. And talking about political stuff. For some reason, when you were talking about the Republicans being elephants, I was hoping for some reason you were going to make a Donald Trump joke.
Ew.
I don't know why, the words just popped in my head. There's probably a way to get there.
I like the response from the audience was a guttural laughing and groaning at the same time.
Oh, yeah. I've been getting a lot of those. Last Thursday, I had this traumatizing show in Seattle where I had an all-O crowd. It was like the only thing, even the funny parts are like, oh! It was very weird. Anyway, they know who they are, you Seattle motherfuckers that were at that show. No, it's okay. No need to. That's always the sound that puts it over the edge. Vanessa Johnson,
Tony
everybody.
Tony lost a whole city.
There she goes. Vanessa Johnson. Your one and only other regular. Started out nervous as hell, slowly calming down every single week. You never know what's going to happen with the stylings of Melissa Esslinger, everybody.
And that is all I have tonight. If you think I'm awkward here, imagine me around a bunch of people I don't know, plus marijuana, plus beer, plus fireworks, and people walking around, and this isn't a joke, so I'm going to get to this. It's not that my kind acts are insincere, it's just that I tend to, like, premature ejaculate, I forgot the word that I made up. I made up a word for that, and it wasn't. Yeah, that's a terrible look. Okay. No. Fuck. Balls. No, I'm not ending there. I can keep go. I mean, Jesus. No, I did have jokes. I'm not.
That's 60 seconds. Melissa Esslinger. Cool. Talking about
nothing at all.
You can see Melissa live at the Meltdown on Wednesday.
Or you can also see her live at the Meltdown every Monday here at 9:35.
No, what I was... All right, here we go.
Melissa, you spent 60 seconds talking about the jokes that you prepared to do for the 60
that I did
seconds
not do.
That you weren't doing the entire time.
Listen, I am...
Dude, that's alt, bro.
Yeah, that's super hip.
Yeah.
The double alt.
Dude, I like that, dude.
So alt that it's almost mainstream.
What?
I like alt.
Yeah, Pat does. Melissa, what were you going to talk about?
Were jokes about being misunderstood.
Nailed it.
Nailed it.
What Tony didn't realize is he was about to be murdered.
Wait, what? Whoa. Whoa, what's this twist? Son of a bitch. Jesus, who's writing this thing? Not even going to be in season 2 of this thing?
No, I...
It's okay. You did. You panicked, and you just did the thing. You fell back on every bad habit.
Well,
exactly. It's okay.
Did the Eminem song get inside your head? Do you think?
I mean, a little bit.
It's too funny.
Can I just say? I mean, follow it. Pushed a random button of Eminem.
Really?
I had no idea what I was playing. I promise. Wow.
I don't know.
I didn't know you were here, so I was just gonna do like an ending song.
Knees weak. Mom's spaghetti. That would fuck anybody up.
I mean.
Okay,
Melissa, did you like smoke weed or drink or anything today?
I smoked weed and I drank some beer.
I've been drinking with Zach all day. Zach introduced me to this alcohol, and I just—it's
all good.
It wasn't. I didn't realize how
it's all good. A special July 4th episode.
Yeah. I was gonna also talk about. I was gonna talk about holidays and how things like make. I was going to talk about ramen noodles and holidays.
Okie dokie. There you go.
I can go there.
No, talk about it next week. There she goes. Melissa Esslinger, everybody. There she goes.
She's talking about it.
There she goes again.
There she goes.
Talking about it.
Hey,
Tony.
Is
this the time we have to end the episode? It is, right? I forget how it works in the belly room. Guys, that's tonight's episode. We have to wrap it up. This is it. Joel Jimenez is on Twitter at Mostly Funny. Anything else, Joel?
Mostly sorry, and then also Jewish man feet on Instagram.
Look at the drawing from Ryan Chaibo, ladies and gentlemen. That happened while you were sitting here. That's tonight's special 4th of July episode. Oh, fuck yeah. Look at me. 4th of July ringleader. Jeremiah Watkins, Pat Reagan. Guys, plug yourselves.
Yes, at Jeremiah Standup on Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, all that stuff. JeremiahWatkins.tv is my website. Guys, July 26th, video on demand. I'm in a movie called The Bet with DDP, Jake the Snake Roberts, Roddy Piper, and some other very funny people. So check that out. And then Roast Battle's coming to Comedy Central at the end of the month.
Yeah. Pat Reagan. You ready to get it?
Check out my shit.
Cleveland, Tulsa, San Fran, Sacramento, San Diego, and Boston. I'm going to be there soon. Live audience, thank you so much. Brian Redband.
See you guys.